Now today I'm sorry I came only for one day because of the response we have had. I've come here quite often and what we found that people were very clueless and they just came down. They didn't take it up seriously. So this time they decided that I should spend only one night here because they thought it was all a waste of energy going down to Bristol. I'm sorry for that. But today I find there are some very nice people sitting down here. In any case, I'm going to Exeter tomorrow for another program. But if we have some more Sahaja Yogis and if you work it out, I'll come definitely for 2-3 days and explain to you all about it. Because its knowledge is so great that you cannot count it. I must have given at least 1,000 lectures so far. And they are all on the tape. But still people say that every time whether you say something new, so you can understand how it is deep and how it is wide. But if you have any questions, please ask me. Relevant to Sahaja Yoga, relevant. If you are coming from any guru, then please, I have nothing to help you. If you are going to represent any guru, I would request you better go. Because you better go to your guru, why should you be here? And why should you ask any question about any guru? Because that's not wrong. You see, if you want, you can have to hire another board and get people and talk about your own. Alright, can I have a
question? Yes, I would like, for the benefit of the audience, just to ask what connection this organisation has with the Divine Light organisation and also with the organisation in India called the Radha Swami Satsang Vyas. Please could you answer this question? But I would like, for the benefit of the audience, to inform the Mataji, married Sri Pans Maharajji, and through him she bore 4 children, one of whom is Guru Maharajji, who was pronounced as a perfect master at the age of 8. Would now count to be...
See, that's
not what
I said, you hire another hall if you are beyond some other...
I'm really informing the audience that one of
Mataji's
sons is present in the drugs to rehabilitate.
See, what
no, this is a different
Mataji. Why
did
you hire another hall? This is like, I said, see, you have made for this hall and you have no business to talk. You have another diamond. This is the hall we have made.
If you're not...
Please don't
no, but this whole film has been an aspect of divine trickery. And if people wish to have their kundalini raised, they could come to the master's
who
raises kundalini in his disciples within a matter of hours.
Please,
the revelation of the 1,000-petal lotus is the beginning of the spiritual journey, not the end.
Well,
in order to attain realization,
what have you got yourself, sir?
In meditation through higher levels of
consciousness. Excuse me, very good fellow, please.
What have you got within yourself?
So
now, I have to
be
interested.
We have an organization called the
You're
very welcome to come along and find out.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Off you go.
Thank you. They can't afford to have a hall for themselves. This is the nonsense about it. See now. What to do?
I would like to ask you once.
Yes,
I have to photograph. Can you tell me? I know they're going to have. How many gods is there? Does it matter what religion you are?
What religion you are?
Nothing. People don't like me.
You don't like me?
They don't like me.
Why?
Because, well, I'm one religion. But to me, there is one God.
Yes, true.
And one God only.
Yes, true.
And we're all heading for the same place.
Yes, true. Very true. Muslims say the same, you say the same.
Yes.
Nothing new about it.
Now, people laugh at me. I see things.
See, you should know.
I do.
That's not good.
I've seen a black hand last night.
Black hand?
A black hand. And they all laugh at me and grin. But let me tell you, I have to tend to a little black boy today.
Black what?
A little black boy he got from over.
What is it?
I have to tell you something else.
Yes, what?
The Lord is coming again.
Alright. Are you prepared?
God bless you.
Are you prepared for that?
Yes.
How?
And why?
How will you make him out?
I know he's coming.
How will you make him out?
I know.
But how will you make him out that he's Lord? There are so many already walking on this.
Tell me.
How will you make
why are people so nasty against one another?
Because they are not realized fools.
What is the greatest thing in the world?
To be realized.
Love. Love is the greatest thing to me in the world. Love one another. But it will never be.
What?
because I can tell you, you are an Indian lady, aren't you? Yes, and if I told you, maybe you laugh at me. I am an Indian guide that helps me. Madam, I'm proud to say, and I don't care who knows it, I am a spiritist. I am a medium.
No,
that you want to welcome here?
No, why?
Because they say I am doing the devil's work.
I will request you not to be a spiritualist, you become the spirit. Alright? I will say as a mother, why are you just a spiritualist? You are playing into the hands of spirits. Why don't you become the spirit? That is your own power. That's what I'm telling you. Alright? And the love that you are talking about is relative love. I'm talking about the love of the spirit. You have to become the spirit. You have to understand this, you see. Unless and until you become the spirit, your powers come from spirits, which are no good. These powers are no good.
And
you should have your own powers, I'm telling you that. Alright?
I'm telling you one thing before I go. God bless you, love. Until we learn to love one another, there's always going to be more.
But how do you learn, madam? How do you learn? You have tried everything, have you not?
I live next to people like you, and little kiddies come up to me and they put their arms around me,
right.
And I don't give them a thing.
Right.
And I said, why do you do that? He said, we love you.
But why?
I said, why? He said, because other people say, oh, nasty things to us. I should take no notice, why should they say nasty things about me? You always say a lot to us. Well, I said, why shouldn't I? You're my sister, I said. And he's my brother.
But by saying it doesn't work out.
I did well, love. Excuse me, I've enjoyed your service.
God bless you one and all. I have to go to work. Although people say, go on strike.
Not me. I will not go on strike in a million years. Not me.
All the strange people coming this time. What is it? Why don't they listen? Just please? Yes, sir.
Why do so-called enlightened people fight each other?
Hate what?
Fight.
Each other?
Fight.
Who are these gurus?
Yes.
You see, they have to fight because they have one. They have to share the same money. It's a marketplace. You see, it's a guru shop. There's a shop somewhere.
There's not enough money involved to make it worthwhile fighting for. Suppose there's no money involved. Why do they still fight?
You see, I have not met anyone who is in the market who doesn't is involved. Most of them are involved in some way or another. Some people who are fighting, they say that they are not involved, but they are in a way. You see, the only way one can understand is that once you make your realization, then what happens? That you cannot fight because you, who is the other to fight? You see, now like this lady talking, you know, I can see her. It's a drama. You see, that you could see her also very clearly. It's a drama. Why we? That she's strange. She's strange. She has to come normal, to become normal. They are abnormal people. That's why they come. They are abnormal because this is abnormal to take somebody's money like this, to deceive someone, to tell lies. This is an abnormal. You see, if you see children, normally they don't tell lies. They don't grab things. They don't know that. They just play a game. That's all. But you see, as we grow, I would say that Indians especially have this capacity to be attached so much to money and all that. But even the Western people have another style of attachment to materialism. You see, there's a subtler one. And Indians made it a gross one. But both are just the same to my mind. Is that the way they are materially attached? And because the matter, according to them, so they think of gives them something special for the fight. The fighting comes because they believe in a mythical thing. Why not fight for the spiritual life? That's why they fight. And if you have to use this fighting, you have to make state of collective consciousness. Only by raising banners, no atomic bomb, and this, you cannot do it. She just cannot do it. Because in the nature of human being, he doesn't know that you are a part and parcel of another person. You see, if you destroy, say, the Chinese, or the Chinese destroy you, they are destroying themselves, that they don't understand. Well, logically also you can say, logically. See, suppose a war starts. Say, suppose it's a war starts. If Americans fight the Russians, and Russians fight the Americans, I wish they finish out themselves. Mm-hmm. The way they are all the time torturing the whole world. You see, everybody is harmed, isn't it? Is it not? That you start a war, and the one who starts, or whether this or that, this is everybody is harmed. So on the whole, it's a problem everywhere. A problem that is with you becomes a problem of everyone. And that's how they don't realize, because they have lost the power of logic in them. Because the wisdom which comes from the spirit is it's the spirit that is one, which gives you this wisdom, innate wisdom to understand. So this gentleman now, I mean, there was no need for him to get up and say something. What has he achieved? Let's see. See, we should ask him, why are you wrong? What is your authority? What have you achieved?
Well, he claims to be an enlightened.
Enlightenment, but enlightenment must show some results. Now, I can say that I have cured even President of India of cancer. All right, has he done something yet? There are at least 10 people sitting here who were suffering from epilepsy, who went to some false groups and cured them. What can he claim? What good has he done for you? Without taking any money from him. Done. They are sitting down here before him. You see, when you talk about something, when you claim something, you should be able to prove it. Supposing I say, I am the Prime Minister of India, will you believe? Now supposing I say, I am, why should you believe? If I say something, I have some powers, isn't it? As Prime Minister, do I manifest those powers? As realized souls, you have certain powers. And if you cannot manifest them, you are not. Simple as that. So they want to keep themselves in delusion and take others into delusion. We should really openly think about and understand. All these organizations which are working out for people must understand that peace must come from within. In without, you cannot have peace. And the within peace is to be achieved through self-realization, because that is the one, is the source of peace, joy and bliss. So we should achieve that. It's a simple thing I'm saying, isn't it? Am I saying something very difficult?
No, I'm still saying, why do all these people fight all the time?
Because they are not the spirits. They are not their spirits. It's simple as that.
They all, everyone of them claim them.
They claim, but whatever one may claim, you must try to feel it. You must try to feel it. Whatever they claim, you must try to feel it. If somebody claims something, you should find out. If somebody, like somebody said, he's Christ, I said, all right, put him on the water, does he go?
Yeah.
If I am saying such and such a thing, you should say, all right, let's see. You must keep yourself open for that. You see, the problem is, one who claims, at least you should say what is the interest. Is there a money interest? Is there a position interest? Is there a power interest? What is the interest of the person? Even if you have doubt, then if such a thing doesn't exist, then what is it? There must be something higher. Because we also, if we live on the same level, we cannot think of somebody who could be higher. Somebody who will do it for love's sake. We cannot think of such a person. That's true, but still, let us have an ideal before us, maybe someone who does it for love, just for love.
I thought perhaps this might lead on to some sort of meditation course or something.
She's expecting this to lead to some form of meditation.
Yes, yes, we'll do that now. First of all, let me pacify your mind, you see. Because at that time, immediately it will start off like a jack in the box, you see, it comes up.
If I may, I would like to ask a question. I've come here tonight for a real reason. I've been very, very ill. I'm still suffering. I have tried to find the right path. I've read many yoga books. I'm a friend of Eusidian in Switzerland. I have been invited, I don't know whether I'm right or not, to the Rama Center in Wellingborough, to Sai Baba's birthday. Whether he is a good or bad, I don't know. But I would like you to advise me and help me before you leave this evening, if you will.
He wants some advice, Mother, as to what course of action to take. He's a little confused, there's a little many possibilities. But he wants your advice before he goes home tonight.
Yes, good idea.
Before you go tonight, I would like to speak with you.
All right, very good. That's like a secret. That's like a secret. It's true. That's great. Fine. Tomorrow morning, when am I going?
We have to be down an extra period early, I think. It's open.
All right, here he is asking. We can take it with us. This is something there, isn't it? Find such people who are seeking the truthfully seeking. Find such people if they are adult, they should be. It's something great. We had one in wisdom, Marcia and Aaron's brother. Just the way they got free. Dining, said, Mother, I'm coming with you, all right? Come along. He came to London, he was staying with us, and wonderful person, I was gone for many. Great, Marcia and we found them here. I'm only sorry that he left Bristol. I wish he had stayed here. But he went to America to search over there. So let's have the meditation as well. Right? Let's see how many of you get. Even if you don't get it, those who are functioning, all of them have it. So why not? You all get it, understand it, master it, and enjoy it. Should we take out our shoes? I have to request you to take out your shoes. It's rather to go down below. Because the Mother Health Care Facility is not on the ground. Now, it's a very simple process as I told you, but these are seven centers, five, six, and seven centers. Now, what you have to do is just to put your hands towards me like this. Just like this. All of you have to do it. Those who don't want to do it should go up. Because they disturb us. Please. There is no show going on here, nothing of the kind. So those who are not going to do it, please go away and oblige us. Don't trouble us for nothing at all. You have no business to trouble us. Did you hear that? Please, those who don't want to have realization should go away. And don't disturb others, like a dog in the mat. You don't want to do it, all right, don't do it. But don't disturb others. Put your hands straight like this. Just straight forward. Put both the feet directly in touch with the body. Just simple as that. All right. And now, you have to close your eyes. Before closing the eyes, you should see that there's nothing tight, but tight on your waist, if it is anything tight here or here. So just try to loosen it a little bit. Now put both the hands straight, close your eyes. Now whatever has to happen, we have to begin. Some of you might feel ascent, some of you may not feel. If it's a very good instrument, you just don't feel it. It just shows up. You don't have to do anything, don't say any mantras, nothing of the kind. Just keep your neck straight and sit comfortably in a very normal way. In a very normal way. Putting no attention, fixing it up anywhere. Just sit in a very normal way. Absolutely in a relaxed way. Please close your eyes. Until I tell you, don't open your eyes for one reason. The reason is this, that the Kundalini doesn't rise above the Ankhachand if your eyes are open. It's no mesmerism, so you have to keep your eyes closed. The happening takes place within. Just keep your eyes shut. Please take out your shoes. All of you take out your shoes. And then sit down comfortably with both the hands.
that will happen is that you will find that there is no thought coming to you. There's no thought coming to you. You reach a state which is called as Nirvichar Samadhi, where you just don't think. You can hear me, you are absolutely alert, but you are thoughtlessly aware. That's the first thing that comes to you. In the second state, you find a cool breeze coming out of your head. That, of course, the Sahaja Yogis can see for themselves, and they will tell you that it is working or not. Then you will find this is coming into your hands. Don't fix your attention in any position or any point. Just keep it loose. The attention will be driven to its destination by Kundalini. You don't have to bother about where to fix the attention, what to do, what not to do. Now put your right hand, closing your eyes, don't close your eyes, on your heart, because that is the place of your spirit. So put your right hand on your heart. Please don't open your eyes. Just put your right hand on your heart, straight forward. And say in your heart, am I the spirit? Mother, am I the spirit? Ask a question like that. Now put the same right hand down below on the stomach, on the left hand side. On the left hand side, put your, press it and ask the question, Mother, am I my own guru? Ask the question 10 times. Mother, am I my own guru? Put the left hand towards me. Keep the left hand towards me. That's important. And then ask the question, Mother, am I my own guru? 10 times. You people are a special category who are seekers, see? A special category, as Blake has called you, men of God. And you have to become prophets, you have to become gurus. Now put this right hand again on your heart. And please say, Mother, I am the spirit. Just assert it, I am the spirit. Say it 12 times. With confidence, please say it with confidence. Don't feel guilty. See, many people have a very bad habit of feeling guilty for nothing at all. Just don't feel guilty. With full confidence, say, Mother, I am the spirit. You are the spirit. Now, what is there to feel guilty about? What guilt can you have? What mistakes can you make before the God Almighty, who is compassionate? Ocean of love. Ocean of forgiveness. So just don't have any guilt. Just say, Mother, I am the spirit, with full confidence, without feeling guilty at all. Now you take it upward to the left side of the neck. Left side of the neck. And put your hand down there, left side of the neck. And just say, Mother, I am not guilty, please. Because all of you have this problem, I believe. For nothing at all. Why do you feel guilty? I just don't understand. For what? Say it 16 times. As I said, He is the ocean of love. He is the ocean of forgiveness. He is the ocean of compassion. Ocean, I'm saying. What do you do so much that you should feel guilty about? These human laws have no place in the eyes of God. Please say it genuinely that you are not guilty. Please say it. Now put this right hand on top of your head. Just see. And in the center where it was a a soft bone in your childhood. You can feel the softness there. Just press it with your fingers. You can feel the softness. Just a little further. It is just find out in the center. Top of the head, in the center of it. It is not so far at back. Just a little further. Towards the forehead more. Little, just move it. In that area you find the soft bone. Now just say whether I want my realization. Because I can't go against your wish, against your desire, against your freedom. So you have to say whether I want my realization. Please give me realization. Just say that. Say it seven times. You should ask for it. Otherwise I cannot force it on you, as I said. Put it with your fingers. Try to press it there. Now raise your hand and see if you feel the cool breeze coming out or a hot breeze coming out. Maybe some hot breeze coming out. You can change your hand now and see with your left hand. But put your right hand towards you. If there's a cool breeze coming out, you can feel it with the left hand. If there's heat coming out, it's a very subtle thing. Little higher. Just see. Put another hand against it. A lot of heat coming out. Rub your hands a little bit and see. The hands have to be sensitive. Feel the heat is coming out. Now yogis can help themselves. You people keep both the hands towards me, or one hand on top and one hand. But so yogis can see. It's very subtle. Let's get there. Some are feeling, isn't it? Now keep it on. Don't think about it. Beyond thinking. Watch it without thinking. You feel my chance? One by one, everybody is going to feel. One by one. So don't worry. Now don't think about it. Put it to your hands. Are you feeling the hands also? Good. What about you now? Not in the hands. Good. I need to work out. What about you, sir? Are you feeling? No. Just see. Let us. Let's go.